गुड आफ्टरनून टू वन एंड ऑल. दिस इज गोपी कृष्णा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम चेबरोल इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज. सब्जेक्ट इज कंपाइलर डिजाइन. सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट previous class we are going to discuss about operator precedence faster. Okay, in this class we are going to discuss about SLR faster using ambiguous grammar. In previously we are discussing SLR parsing, simple LR parsing in unambiguous grammar. So unambiguous means, so grammar is ambiguous or unambiguous, whatever it is, we are using to construct SLR parser by using ambiguous or unambiguous. So before going to discuss, so LR parsers are used to, you are using the bottom up parsing techniques, and in a simple LR parsing technique we are having some disadvantages. So we are going to construct the given grammar. So that means what are the disadvantages means, in this one we are going to construct a parsing table. It is a new table in a grammar. So in terminal ekku unte manaki LR SLR parser lo table size anedi ekku untundi, okay na. So alanti alage SLR parsing lo we have multiple entries we are having. So మల్టిపుల్ ఎంట్రీస్ వచ్చినప్పుడు కూడా మనకి ఆ ప్రాబ్లం అనేది అక్కడ అవుతుంది. సో అందుకని మనం ఎస్ఎల్ఆర్ పార్సర్ లో ఆ మల్టిపుల్ ఎంట్రీస్ ని రిడ్యూస్ చేయడానికి కెనానికల్ ఎల్ఆర్ పార్సింగ్ ని యూజ్ చేస్తాం. ఓకే, సో కెనానికల్ ఎల్ఆర్ పార్సింగ్, దెర్ ఇస్ నో మల్టిపుల్ ఎంట్రీస్ అండ్ వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు ఓవర్కమ్ ద డ్రాబ్యాక్. దట్ మీన్స్ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ టేబుల్ సైజ్ ఈజ్ లార్జ్, దెన్ వీ గో ఫర్ ద ఎల్ఏఎల్ఆర్ పార్సింగ్. సో ఎల్ఏఎల్ఆర్ పార్సింగ్ ఈజ్ యూజ్ టు construct the parse table by using, how to reduce the number of states. Okay, so in this we are going to reduce the number of states, but we are having the multiple entries that are present in our LALR parser. So before coming to these three LR parsers, which one is efficient? That means we are using canonical LR parsing is efficient than the other SLR and LALR. So canonical LR parsing is the efficient LR parsing we are using. Okay, so what is the example of SLR parsing using ambiguous grammar? So in this ambiguous grammar we are using SLR parser, we can get multiple entries in our parsing table. So how to overcome those entries are eliminated by using this example. So now let us see the example of LR parser for the grammar. Here this is the example. So here construct SLR parsing table for the ambiguous grammar. So the productions are E produces E plus E, or E E star E, or open brace capital E, closed brace or ID. So this is the given grammar. We have to construct the parsing table and also parse the input string is ID plus open brace. So this is the input string we have to parse. So what is the steps we are going to construct the SLR parsing technique? So we are having, the first step is write the augmented grammar, and second one is the calculate the canonical collection of LR of zero items, and third one is the design of finite automata, and fourth one is the construction of SLR parsing table, and fifth one is the parse the input string. So this is the five steps. These are the five steps we are using to construct the SLR parser, right? So what is the step one? So step one, we are writing the augmented grammar. So what is augmented grammar? Okay, so we are adding one production to that given grammar. That grammar converts the augmented grammar. So which production we are going to add? So in our grammar, what is the starting state? So in our grammar, capital E is the starting state. Then we are going to add the production to that particular grammar. Then the grammar becomes augmented grammar. The production is E bar is production with capital E. this is the we are added the production to the given grammar, that grammar becomes the augmented grammar. So e bar is production with capital E, that is the augmented production. So next, what are the productions here? Capital E production with E plus E, and capital E produces E star E, and capital E produces open brace, capital E closed brace, and E is produced with idle. So this is the remaining productions for the given grammar. So we are only added the augmented production. So one production we are going to add, that production is called E bar is production with capital E. So that is the given production, right? So what is the step two? We are going to calculate the canonical collection of LR of zero items. All of you know how to calculate the LR of zero items. So we are going to write LR of zero item. So what is an item? We are going to place dot at the beginning of the right side of every production, that becomes the item. Okay, so that is the given given grammar is converted into item. So what is the step two here? Calculate the canonical collection of LR of zero item, right? So here the second step is, so we have to calculate the canonical collection of LR of zero item. Okay, so here first, what is the first one? So E bar is production with the dot. So we are placing dot at the beginning of the right side, that production becomes the item. Okay, so E bar is production with the dot E. So consider this production, after the dot we have a non-terminal capital E. So we have a non-terminal capital E, then we have to write the productions of capital E. So our productions capital E ki evaithe productions unnayo aa productions anni raayali. So we are writing the all the productions of capital E. So here E produces, we are adding dot at the beginning of the starting production. Okay, that becomes an item. Okay, so here we are going to write the productions here. So E is produces dot E plus E, and E is production with dot E star E, and E is production with dot open brace capital E closed brace, and E is production with dot ID. Okay, so we are writing all the productions of capital E. Okay, then considering this production, considering second production, so after the dot we have a non-terminal capital E. We have a non-terminal capital E. Then add the productions of capital E. Already we are adding all the productions of capital E. No need to again add the productions of capital E. And here after the dot we have capital E. Then add the productions of capital E. Already we are adding the productions of capital E. No need to again add the production. And here capital E. After the dot we have a terminal. Is there any production with terminal open brace where the augmented grammar? There is no production. There is no production with open brace. Okay. And considering this this production, so that is E is production with dot ID. E is production with dot ID. So dot, after the dot we have a terminal ID. Is there any production with ID in the augmented grammar? There is no production with ID. Okay, no need to write the production. So we have to check all the productions in this given. After the dot we have a terminal or non-terminal, we can write the productions we are using in the closure property. Okay, so then after completing all the closure properties of this non-terminals and terminals, then we have to name this one as I naught, state I naught. Okay, so I naught is the first state. Okay, then we are going to write the go to function. So what is the use of go to function? So go to function is used to we can apply the go to function on the production. So the dot is moving one position to the right. That means we are going to calculate the final items in the particular given grammar. So we are going to apply the go to function. So we are going to apply go to function on E. So here after the dot we have how many production? Oh, here after the dot one production, after the dot capital E another production, after the dot capital E three productions with capital E. Then we have to apply the go to one I naught comma capital E. So here go to I naught comma capital E. Then the productions become here E bar is production with dot is moving one position to the right. Why? Because we are applying go to function. So this dot is moving one position to the right. Then the production becomes E bar is production with E dot. So here after the dot, is there any terminal or non terminal? There is no terminal and there is no on terminal. So here next one, after the dot we have one more capital E is the another terminal. Then we are applying go to on capital E. Then the production becomes E is produced with E dot plus capital E, and E is production with E star E dot star capital E. Okay, so we are writing the productions of dot E. So we are going to apply the go to of I naught comma capital E. So these are the three productions with capital E. Then the dot is moving one position to the right. So here we are considering the second production. So after the dot, is there any, we have a terminal plus. So we are in our augmented grammar, is there any productions with the plus? There is no productions with the plus, then no need to include the production. And here considering third production, after the dot we have a star, then no need to there is no productions with the star, then no need to include the production. So this is the completion of go to of I naught comma capital E. Then we are naming the new name for this particular state. So that is the I1. Okay. Okay. Then we are going to apply go to of I naught comma E completed, and we are going to apply go to of open brace I naught comma open brace. So here we are applying go to of I naught comma open brace. So the production becomes E produces dot is moving one position to the right. Then the production becomes E produces open brace dot E. Okay. So here we are considering this production. After the dot we have a non-terminal capital E. Then add the productions of capital E. So what are the productions of capital E? So E produces dot E plus E. E produces dot E star E, and E produces dot open brace E close brace, and E produces dot ID. Okay, these are the productions of capital E. So we are applying this one closure property on this one. So we are going to write all the productions of capital E. So considering this one, after the dot we have a non-terminal capital E. Then add the productions of capital E. Already we are adding the productions of capital E. No need to again include the production. And here also same dot E. So already we are adding the productions of capital E. So here after the dot we have a open brace. Then what are the productions? Is there any productions with open brace? There is no production. And after the dot we have ID. Then what are the product? Is there any productions of ID in augmented grammar? So there is no productions with ID. So no need to expand this one. So here I1 is completed. Then we are naming the new state with I2. Is it clear? Then go to of, we are applying ID. Go to of I0 comma ID. So we are going to apply the go to of I0 comma ID. Then the production becomes E produces ID dot. Okay. So we are applying go to, the dot is moving on position to the right. Production becomes E produces ID dot. So is there any productions after the dot? After the dot we have a, is there any terminal or non-terminal? There is no terminal and there is no non-terminal. Then no need to expand this one. So we are I2 is state is completed. Then we are naming the state is I3. Okay. Then go to of I0 is completed. So coming to go to of I1. So go to of I1. So here first production, after that we have a, there is no terminal and there is no non-terminal. No need to apply go to on this case, this production. So here after the dot we have a terminal plus, and after that we have a terminal star. So So we are going to apply the go to of I1 comma plus and go to of I1 comma star. So we are applying go to of I1 comma plus. So what is the production become? So this dot is moving one position to the right. So the production becomes E produces E plus dot E. So considering this production, after the dot we have a non-terminal capital E. Then add the productions of capital E. So what are the productions of capital E? E produces dot E plus E. E produces dot E star E and E produces open dot open brace close brace E and E produces dot ID. Okay. So already we are adding the productions of capital E. There is no need to add the one more time the production. Okay. So here I3 state is completed. Then we are naming the new state with I4. Okay, then go to of I1 comma plus is completed. Then we are applying go to of I1 comma star. So we are applying go to of I1 comma star. So here we are using the production becomes E produces E star dot E. So we are applying go to, this dot is moving one position to the right. So after the dot we have a terminal, non-terminal capital E. Then add the production of capital E. So what are the productions of capital E? E produces E plus E. So dot E plus E and E produces dot E star E. E produces dot open brace E close brace and E produces dot ID. So these are the productions. So here after the dot considering second production, after the dot we have a non-terminal capital. Then add the productions of, already we are adding the productions of capital E. Then no need to again include the production. So here I4 state is completed. Then we are naming the new state name, that is I5. Then so go to of I1 is completed. Then we are going to apply go to of I2. Okay, so in go to of I2, so after the dot we have a non-terminal capital E and after the dot we have a terminal open brace and after the dot we have a terminal ID. So we are applying the go to of E open brace and ID. So go to of I2 comma capital E we are applying. So go to of I2 comma capital E, then the production becomes, so we are applying go to, this dot is moving one position to the right. The production becomes E produces open brace capital E dot closed brace and E produces E dot plus E and E produces E dot star E. So these are the production. So considering first production, after the dot we have a terminal. Then no need to include the production. Why? Because it is a terminal. Then in our augmented grammar, there is no production with the closed brace. And here, is there any production with plus? There is no production. And is there any production with star? There is no production. So no need to include the productions of open brace, closed brace, star, plus. Okay, so here this is the production. So I5 is completed. Considering this production, it is E bar is production with E dot. So here E is production with open brace, E dot. So there is a difference between these two states. Then I5 state is completed. Then we are adding the, we are naming the new state, that is I6. Okay. I6. So this is the state I6. Then we are going to apply go to of E is completed and go to of open brace we are applying. So go to of I2 comma open brace. Then we are going to apply. So we are applying E produces, dot is moving one position to the right. Then the production becomes E produces open brace dot E close brace and E produces dot E plus E, E produces dot E star E, E produces dot open brace E closed brace E produces I. So is this production is equal to the state I2? Equal or not equal? Equal or not equal? Equal. Okay, then we are going to name the same state name with this one. So I2 is the state name, then we are naming the same state to this production. So I2 is the production. Okay, I2 is the statement. Then go to of id. So id, we are applying go to of i2 comma id. So this dot is moving one position to the right. And the production becomes IE produces id dot. So already we are having the state i3, then naming the same name to this particular production. So i3 is completed. So we are going to apply go to of i2 is completed. So then go to of i3. So here is the final production and no need to apply the go to function. So we are going to apply the go to of i4. So after the dot we have e and we have open brace and we have id. So then we are going to apply go to of i4 comma capital E and go to of i4 comma open brace and go to of i4 comma id, right? So we are going to apply go to of i4 comma capital E. Then the production becomes E produces E plus E dot, E plus E dot, and E produces E dot plus E, and E produces E dot star E. Okay, so is their production is equal to any other production? So coming checking with I6 and I7, so first production is different and second third is equal. Then no need to name the same state name. Why? Because so the productions are different. Then we are going to define the new state name. So I6 is completed. Then we are using I7. Okay. Then we are going to apply go to of I4 comma open brace. Go to of I4 comma open brace. Then here go to of I4 comma open brace. The production becomes E produces open brace dot E. So after the dot we have a non-terminal capital E. Then add the production of capital E. So E produces dot E plus E, E produces dot E star E, E produces dot open brace E close brace, and E produces dot ID. Okay, so here these productions is equal to the state I2. Then name the same state name to this particular one I2 and go to of I4 comma ID. So we are applying go to on E produces dot ID. The production becomes E produces ID dot. So this is the existing production, that is I3. We are naming the same state name to this particular one I3. Then go to of I4 is completed. We are going to apply go to of I5. So after the dot we have capital E, after the dot we have open brace, after the dot we have ID. Then we are going to apply the go to of I5 comma capital E. Then the production becomes E produces E star E dot, and E after the, and here E produces E dot plus E, E produces E dot star E. So these are the different productions. So I7 is completed. Then we are going to use the different state name, that is I8. So we are naming the different state name, that is I8. Then go to of I5 comma open brace. So I5 comma open brace. So E produces open brace dot E closed brace. So after the dot we have a non-terminal capital E. Then add the productions of capital E. So here productions of capital E is E produces dot E plus E, E produces dot E star E, E produces dot open brace closed brace, and E produces dot ID. So these are the productions are equal to the state ID. Okay, so then we are naming the same state name to that particular production. So I2 is the state. Then we are going to apply the go to of I5 comma ID. So the production becomes E produces ID dot. Then the production becomes, so here is the I3. So then we are going to name the same state name to that particular product. So I3 is state name, then we are naming same state name. Then I5 is completed. We are going to apply go to on I6. So after the dot we have a right parenthesis, and after the dot we have plus, and after the dot we have star. Then I'm going to apply the go to on I6 comma closer brace, and go to of I6 comma plus, and go to of I6 comma star. Right. Go to of I fixed comma closed brace. Then the production becomes E produces open brace E closed brace dot. Okay. So here after the dot we have no terminal, no non-terminal. Then we have to stop this. Okay. Then we are naming the different state name. That is I8 is completed. We are naming the I9. Okay. Then we are applying go to of I6 comma plus. Okay. So I6 comma plus E produces E plus dot E. So here after the dot we have a non-terminal capital. Then add the productions of capital E. So what are the productions of capital E? E produces dot E plus E. E produces dot E star E. E produces open with E closed with E produces I. So this is the existing state. So that is I4. So then we are naming the same state name to this particular production. So I4 is the same state name. We are naming the same state. Then go to our I6 comma star. So E produces. So I6 comma star means this star is moving one position to the right. In the production star, E produces E star dot E. E produces dot E plus E. E produces dot E star E. E produces dot E. Open brace E, closed brace E produces dot I. So these productions are existing already. So those are state I5. Then we are naming the same state name. This is I5. Okay. Then we are applying I6 is completed. And we are going to apply the I2. Already we are going to apply both on I2 and I3. So it is a final production. No need to apply both I7. So we are going to apply I7, go to on I7. So in this first production is the final production. So no need to apply this one. So E produces E plus. So we are going to apply go to of I7 comma plus and go to of I7 comma star. So go to of I7 comma plus. We are applying the go to E produces E plus dot E. So after the dot we have a non-terminal capital E, then they add the productions of capital E. So what are the productions of capital E? E produces dot E plus E. E produces dot E star E. E produces dot open brace E closed brace and E produces dot ID. Okay. So these productions already existing in the state I4. Then we are naming the same state name I4. And go to our I7 comma star. So E produces E star dot E. After the dot we have a non-terminal capital E. Then add the productions of capital E. E produces dot E plus E. E produces dot E star E. E produces dot open brace capital E closed brace and E produces dot I. So these productions are already existing in the state I5. Then we are naming the same state name, that is I5. Then I7 is completed. I2 already we are applying go to on I2. I3 it is a final production. No need to apply go to I8. So we are applying go to on I8. So I8 comma plus and I8 comma star. So in this final first production is a final production. No need to apply go to on first production. So here go to of I8 comma plus. The production becomes E produces E plus dot E. So after the dot we have non-terminal capital E. Then add the production of capital E. So this is the state of already existing I4. Then naming the same state. And go to of I8 comma star. So we are applying go to E produces E star dot E. So after the dot we have a non-terminal capital E. Then add the productions of capital E. Okay. Then what are the productions of capital E? E produces dot E plus E. E produces dot E star E. E produces dot open brace E closed brace and E produces dot ID. So these are the productions with I5, then I8 is completed. I2 already we are applying go to on I2 and I3 it is a final production. I9, so it is also final production. No need to apply go to I4 already completed. I5 already completed. I4 already. I5. So there is no new state with go to. We are going to apply go to. So this is the calculation of canonical LR of 0 item. Okay, is there any doubt with this one? Already we are discussing in two examples, we are calculating the LR of zero items in SLR passing examples. Okay, so one more example with ambiguous grammar, we are calculating the canonical collection of LR of zero items. Okay, so what is the step 3? We are going to construct a design a finite automata. So we are using go to function I naught capital E go to I1. So this is the finite automata we are going to construct. So what is next step 4? So we have to construct the SLR parsing table for this ambiguous grammar. So in this step 4, so here construction of SLR parsing table. So what are the fields? So in this rows we are using number of states. So in this example, we are getting 9 total, 10 states, so from 0 to 9, and we are using action, and in columns we are using action and go to part. So in action part we are using only terminals, and go to part we are using only non terminals. So in our given grammar, we have terminals is id star plus open brace, closed brace, and dollar. So in go to function we have only one non terminal, that is capital G. So we are placing rows as state numbers and columns as terminals with action, and go to its non terminal. So how to fill this one? So we are using canonical LR of zero items. Okay, so here is, so go to of I naught comma capital G. So go to off. So here is the state I naught. So 0th state with capital G. So it's going to state I1. So we are filling 0th state with capital E non terminal. We are filling 1. Okay. So here 0th row in capital E we are going to write I1. Okay, 1. Then go to off I naught comma open brace. So open brace is a terminal or non terminal? This is a terminal. So we are filling the SLR parsing table with the terminal, then we are going to write the shift operation. So we are using ES. Okay, so here go to of I naught comma open brace, so it is I2. So that is S2 on open brace. So 0th row with open brace S2, right? Then go to of I naught comma id. So in 0th row with id, it is a terminal. Then we are using shift operation. So S3 in writing id 0th row. So S3. Okay, is it clear? Then go to of I1. So here go to of I1 comma plus. So plus is a terminal, then we are using shift operation. So go to of plus and star, we are using S4 and S5. We are using plus and star in the state 1. So S4, S5. Okay, so here in the first state, so we are using augmented grammar E-H is production with E dot final. So then we are using accept at the dollar in every parser. Either it is SLR parsing, it is LR parsing, in LLR parsing, we are using in the first row with dollar, we are going to act. Next one, go to of I2 comma capital G. So in this second row with capital G, it is going to write I6, state 6. So we are writing simply 6 on capital E with the second row. Second row with capital E, we are writing simply 6. Then go to of I2 comma open brace. So open brace is a terminal. Then we are writing shift operation. So I2 and I3 with open brace and ID. So S2 with open brace and S3 with ID. Okay. Then I2 is completed. Then go to of I4 comma capital E. So in this fourth row we are having capital G, then I7. So we are naming just 7 on to the capital V. So we are writing just in fourth row capital V we are using 7, right? Then go to off I4 comma open brace. So it is a terminal. We are writing shift operation. S2 and S3 with open brace S2 and ID with S3. So we are writing open brace with S2 and in fourth row S3. Okay. Then go to off I5 comma capital V. So I5 comma capital V. Go to off I5 comma capital E. So in the fifth row we are using non-terminal capital E. Then we are writing 8. So we are writing just state name 8 onto the table. So the table becomes in fifth row we are using capital E with 8. Then go to off I5 comma open brace. So it is a terminal. Then we are using shift operation. So S2 and S3 on fifth row. So in fifth row, open brace S2 and so ID with S3. Then I5 is completed. So I6 with closed brace. So it is I9. So we are closed brace is a terminal. So we are using shift operation S9 on closed brace with fifth row. So in sixth row with S9 on closed brace, right? Then I6 comma plus and I6 comma star. So we are going to shift four and shift five onto the table. So we are writing shift four on plus and shift five on star. Right, next one. Go to off I7 plus I7 star. So I4, I5. So shift 4 and shift 5 on 7th row. 7th row, we are using shift 4 and shift 5 with plus and star. Right? Next one, I8 comma plus. So in 8th row, this is a terminal. We are writing shift off S4 and S5. We are writing in 8th row. So the table becomes in 8th row we are using S4 and S5 with plus and star respectively. Okay, so shift operations, go to function is completed. Then what are the final items we are getting in canonical LR of 0 items? So the final items are in I1 state we are having one final item, in I3 state we have one, I7 we have one, I8 we have one, and I9. So we are writing the reduce operation. So how to write the reduce operation? In our given grammar, we have to give the production numbers to the grammar. So the production numbers becomes, here is the production. So E dash is production with capital E, and E production with E plus E, and E production with E star E, E production with open brace, E closed brace, and E production with ID. So we are having 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we are writing production number by using reduce operations with the final item. So in I1 state, so E produces E dot. So this is the final item. So we can write in the first row with the dollar we are using access. So before going to write shift operation, we have to calculate the first and follow of capital E. So we have only one non-terminal capital E, then we have to calculate the first half capital E. So production is here is the production. So what is the first of E? So E, we have a terminal open brace and ID. So the first of E is open brace ID and follow of E. So follow of E means, so here follow of E, E is the end of the, so here E is the plus. So follow of E means plus, follow of E means star, and follow of E means closed brace, and in every production we have a dollar. So this is the fall off capital E becomes dollar plus star closed brace. Okay, so this is the fall off capital E. Then we are writing shift operation. So I3. So in I3 state we are having E production with ID. So in the third row, So what is the production number here? E production ID. So it is a fourth production. So we are writing R4 onto the follow up. So follow up E means plus star dollar closed blade. So we are writing in the third row R4 in plus, R4 in star, R4 is in open brace, sorry, closed brace and a dollar. We are writing reduced productions on this one. Okay, next one. In I7, in the seventh row, E produces E plus E dot. So in the seventh row, E produces E plus E dot. So what is the production number of E plus E? E produces E plus E dot. So the production number is 1. We are writing in the seventh row. Seventh row, we are writing R1, 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 R1. So why? Because we are writing R1 in 4 terminals. So this is the follow up capital. We are writing. In these places, we are writing reduced production. So R1, 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 R1. And here, next one, I8, E produces E star E dot. So here, what is the production number 2? Then we are writing follow up E means dollar plus star closed brace. So R2, 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 R2. And I9, E produces open brace, E closed brace dot. So in the 9th row, we are writing this one. So the production number is 3. The follow up capital E is the 1 plus star closed brace and dollar. So this is the way we are filling the reduce operation. In reduce operation, we have to fill the production number only, not a state number, right? So this is the construction of SLR parsing table. So in this parsing table, we have multiple entries here. Okay, so 561. Hello. Hello. So in previous example, we have one multiple entry for that one. So we have to calculate. We have to use which operation, shift operation or reduce operation. So in this one, we are having shift and reduce conflicts in SLR parsing, and in CLR parsing, we have only reduce conflicts. In LALR, there is no in CLR, no conflicts are occur. In LALR, we are having reduced conflict. So the best efficient one is CLR parsing. So here is the shift reduce conflict here. So how we are using this one? So which operation we are going to use? So for this one. So in this table, we have multiple entries. Those can be eliminated by considering the precedence and associativity. So precedence ni associativity ni use chesi mano ee shift perform cheyala reduce perform cheyala cheptam. So in our state 7 and state 8, we have multiple entries. Okay, so in state 7 has shift reduce conflict for the symbol plus and star. So in this one, so in seventh state, what is the production R1? So reduce 1 and what is the production number 1? E produces E plus. So I0 ninchi E production I1 and plus this one I4 and capital E this one I7 killing. So when we are using the current symbol, so 7 with plus this one, 7 with plus current symbol is plus this one. So plus we are using plus, and in this conflict we are using plus only. So plus to plus vachinappudu we are follow the left associative. We are using left associative. Okay, so left associative teeskunte we are performing reduce operation. So if the current symbol is star, the current symbol is star, and here we are having plus, current symbol is star and we are having plus. So then we can check the precedence. So star having the highest precedence than the plus. So we are performing shift operation only. Okay, are you getting? So in this production, so reduce one means So we are having the first production. E produces E plus. So here having plus. And in our state, so in the seventh state, we are having plus and star. So we are considering this one. So plus is the current symbol or token. So we can perform shift or reduce. We are performing only one action. So how we are know which action we are going to perform? So here, so plus is the current symbol and here is the plus. Then we are going to perform the left associative. So reduce operation only we can perform. And here the current token is star. Then here is the plus. Then we are going to check the precedence. So we are going to perform shift when star has the highest precedence. So we are going to perform shift operation. So star having the highest precedence, then the plus. So we are performing shift here, and here we are performing reduce. Then in state 8, so in state 8 we are having shift reduce conflict for the symbols plus and star. So in our table, in our table 8th row, we are having reduce 2. Reduce 2 means its state is the production number is 2. So E produces E star E. So here E produces E star E. So I naught, I 1, I 5, I 8. Okay, so this is the production, and we are reading the current token is star. So token star ikkada star. Em avutundi? A operation perform cheyali. We are going to perform shift or reduce. So we are using so same precedence symbols. We are performing the left associative, that is the reduce operation. Correct. Coming to next one, when the current token is plus. Current token is plus. So here is the star. Then what is the highest precedence? So shift is the highest precedence. Plus has the highest precedence, then star. And reduce has the star has the highest precedence, then plus. So we are using these functions. We have to perform the shift and reduce operation. So in our SLR passing table, we have 2, 4 multiple entries. So 7 plus. So 7 plus in the state 7. The current symbol is plus, and here current symbol is plus, and we are having the plus. So plus ikkada undi, man current symbol plus vachindi. Em cheyali? We are performing the left associative. So we are performing reduce operation. Okay, so we are performing reduce operation, not shift. And here 7 comma star. So the current symbol is star, and given one is plus. So star having the highest precedence, then we are performing the shift operation. So here is the shift operation. So star has the highest precedence, then star, right? Next one. So in this one, 8 comma plus. So in this 8th state, we have a symbol E star E. So in our example, star and E. Okay. So star vachindi ikkada plus vachindi. So em cheyali? Shift operation or reduce operation? Reduce operation. Why? Because so plus star is the highest precedence, then star. Okay, sorry, plus. Then here the current symbol is star, and our symbol is star. So both stars. So em avutundi? Rendu star aithe we are using reduce operation, but means left associative. So we are performing reduce here also. Star having the highest precedence, we are performing reduce. So in this way we are performing the table having the multiple entries. Okay, is it clear? So in this one, parse the input string id plus open brace. So $0. So we can get finally, in this example, we can get $2. So in our table, $2, there is no operation. So we can get the errors. So in this way, we are getting some errors. So how to recover from those errors? By using two panic mode recovery and error mode recovery. And two only, we can see in the next class. Okay, so with this example, we have to understand we can get multiple entries that are present in our table. Table lo multiple entries vachinappudu ye operation perform cheyalanadi by using this notes we can right? Shutta operation as well as reduce operation. Okay, so in this way we can get this error. Why? Because $2 there is no entry, so we can get the error. So how to recover those errors? By using the panic mode recovery and another recovery technique. So you can see in the next class with those recovery models. Okay, is there any doubt with this one? Anyone?